I'ma show how it's done.
I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm an old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm an old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a suffer. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter.
Look, I played the game, I missed a shot. I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance, for not, my not, my not. For lexing, I fell out and cut the check. My not, my not. Palaz the set, but I bet I been taking hits like I can die like innocent. Morning of the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop it. The nigga, the surfer, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping a run, popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in the land. So most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand, the colors are mixing again. Grabbing a stick with my hand, I drop my guts. The world is us, so what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust, kicking the door when I come at the cut. Well, yeah. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust, do what I do and I say what I want. Well, yeah, mama, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack on my jacket at Grammy. We see the audacity. I was a bad kid, bad city. You see the duality. Who tryna battle me, huh? Hitters is after me. Can I be dabbing me? Who wanna pump me up? Fatality really is up. It's up, undoubtedly. Baby gon' touch the bucks. My salary double. Your baby daddy maybe triple. I'm trouble. I get the tackle and the pick and I hustle. I had to have it. Had to get in the huddle, in the gravel and rubble. Got me a second. I'm tryna be subtle. We just hacking like a dog with a muzzle. See the bagger, put him back in the puddle. We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the options. Send big blitz. Nobody blocking big wind, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot, trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting that's your partner, then your twin game. All you wanna do is talk, I don't need talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the locker. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of the pocket, but I rock with the game.
Animosity was out inside of me, so I'm not the product of Broadway.
Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut. Okay. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut. Okay. I need more, don't want your bro. It was for show, just so you know.
We just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, money, mo. All this money, I need more. Don't want your bro. It was for show, just so you know. We just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, money, mo. All this money, I need more. Give them a show. Taking your bros, I'm taking your man and spinning his bands. Oh yeah, did it again. Oh yeah, out with his friend. Oh yeah, Chanel is the lens.
Okay.
With his friend finna get lit. I'm everything on they wish list. Which bag should I get? Which color should I pick? Pick. Any, mini, money, mo. All his money, I need mo. You big bro, gotta go. Big bird giving crow. A group of baddies coming foe. Give me money, kiss my toes. Don't with your bro, it was for show. Just so you know, we just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, miny, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro. It was for show. Just so you know. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit.
We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, money, mo. All this money, I need mo. Give him a show, killing you knows and taking your bro. We just wanna get lit.
Still a bit warm here in Florida, but really, all things considered, a wonderful fall afternoon for football here in Tampa at Raymond James Stadium. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with the Miami Dolphins. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. On first down, Brady. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. This defense for the Dolphins, they were excellent a week ago in that victory over Indianapolis.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard. This defense for the Dolphins, they were excellent a week ago in that victory over Indianapolis.
It was a little bit enlightening talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week, because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win. But definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
Brady to throw on third and one. And this is going to be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. No return, but it goes down as just a punt of 31 yards. And it'll be Dolphin football. And now the Bucs deciding to take a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Two in the Dolphins now with a first and 10 right at the 30. And he's got a good gain of 7 up to the 37. This defense for the Buccaneers, they were strong last week, CD, and that went over New England.
And every defensive team that we talk to, they spend a lot of time talking about creating turnovers. And anytime you get two or more in a game, you've had a really good performance. They exceeded that number in a huge way. They got the football back 4 times in the win.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Dolphins first down. Midfield and down into Buccaneer territory. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. Got a man, it's the rookie Jalen Waddle. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 23. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
So Tua making the completion there. What's different about playing a left-handed quarterback like him? And specifically, I guess, what does this defense need to try and take away?
I'll take the first part that you asked about being left-handed. We've got to find out if he can move to his right and still continue to be accurate. So I want to push him in that direction and see if he can get his body squared around and make those throws that he's used to making. The next part is, he's a dart thrower. Loves those short to intermediate routes first. Sit on those and make him throw the deep ball. Not that he's not capable, but you want him to prove it to you first.
on play action. Here's Tua looking for the end zone. That is caught by Waddle. Touchdown, Miami. Jalen Waddle, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Dolphins are on the board first here on the road in Tampa. Jason Sanders now for the extra point. And that makes it 7-0 Dolphins.
Makes the score Dolphins 7. Buccaneers nothing. Jason Sanders.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Offense set to begin their next possession, and they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went three and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion, guys a little bit jumpy.
You do.
Oh, you understand the same way. It's just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went
and
three and out.
And now they have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go three and out. I went three and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Now a carry for Bernard. And he'll take it forward for about five up to the 28-yard line.
This defense for the Dolphins, they were excellent a week ago in that victory over Indianapolis.
But we certainly had a nice conversation with the defensive coordinator, didn't we? And what we heard, I like what we did, but we definitely need more pressure on the quarterback this week.
Throwing is Brady on third down. He's going deep for Brown. And that will be incomplete. They weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. Here's Bradley Pinion now as he'll punt it away for the second time. Yikes. Terrible kick headed straight for the sidelines. And where will this be spotted? The side judge says it went out just across midfield. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they'll be looking to make this a two-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their first drive, Charles. Hey, they can get up two scores here on the road. That's a heck of a start. And there he goes, left side. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown.
So there, Charles, I mean, a situation where it didn't matter how far he had to run, he was not going to be denied, and he winds up taking this all the way to the end zone.
Extra point up and good by Sanders, and it's now 14-0. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. Not only are they in search of their first score, they're in search of their first down in this ballgame as they come up first and 10. Brady's throw taken in by Evans here. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down.
And Mike Evans has been the model of consistency and excellence. 7 years in the league, he's been a 1,000-yard receiver. Seven times the first guy in league history to do that. And he makes another catch there for a first down.
Throwing on first down is Brady. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there. And it's second down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 22 yards there, a first down.
And there's a familiar sight, Rob Gronkowski making a catch for a first down. And remember, Gronk said he was done in 2019, was out of football after retiring from the Patriots. But Brady asked if he'd run it back with him in Tampa, and he answered the call. Gronk earned his fourth ring with the win in Super Bowl 55, a game in which he scored two touchdowns.
Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here, and now they're set up with a first and goal.
First time into the red zone for the Buccaneers. They're looking at a first and goal from about the 9. Now Brady again. And he's got his tight end, Howard. It's a Buccaneer touchdown. O.J. Howard, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bucs have made this a one-score game. Extra point up and good by Sucker. And that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Here comes Philip Dorsett now to return it. And he won't quite make it to the 25.
Keep playing on.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big-time jaunt? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
Remain for second down. Tua sets up to pass it. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Dolphins first down.
Well, I like the play design there. They occupied the defense downfield, everyone trying to account for someone. But unfortunately, they didn't account for the running back slipping out of the backfield, and he was absolutely unnoticed and wound up getting big yards on that play.
A lane opens up that time as he'll be brought down just short of a first after a gain of about 9.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line.
Well, you know, this club, there were some reports earlier in the week, and most have heard this by now, the so-called unnamed sources that were saying all is not rosy in that locker room. There's whispers that one or two guys, CD, have kind of had enough of how things are going and have been going. How would you handle that as a coach?
Well, you and I both know all the coaches that we've dealt with and come in contact with. They'd love to get their hands on those unnamed sources, wouldn't they? But they know that that's not possible. So I think they've got to go in there and make sure that this isn't a distraction. They also know that once the grumbling starts, it becomes a slippery slope and it's hard to stop the fall. But I think you need to sit some guys down and say, hey, look, we're still hoping to be a playoff team this year. We need you guys to be bought in with what we're doing. Come on, let's get on board.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. Now Ballage. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4. Now Tua. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Tua finding Gesicki there for a Dolphin first.
They brought in a heavy set on third down, and that usually means running play, but we have seen them throw out of that formation. And sure enough, they snuck the tight end out on that one, wound up hitting him for a first down.
Balaj. And a good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Second down and three. They'll run here with Balaj, and he's eaten up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16. But keep in mind, if you're thinking of staying on the ground, this is a top five rush defense.
Yeah, but I don't think you shy away totally with the run. At least show them the hint of a run before you decide to throw the football.
Ninth play coming up here on this drive. This is third and a yard. They run it with Balaj, and he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Sanders is good, and they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. So a nice kick there as they are able to add on to their lead.
And that's exactly what you're looking to do. Maneuver yourself into range. That way, if your drive stalls out, you're able to get something out of it, and they do so right there.
And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
57 to Mike. 57 to Mike. Watch QB
drop. Regular.
Watch QB drop. 57 to Mike.
To throw, it's Brady. That's complete. It's Chris Godwin. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards. First and 10 here, and you know, if they could just get three out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jerome Baker.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
After the turnover, it's Tua. He'll take a shot for the end zone. There's Fuller for a Dolphin touchdown.
Give me the ball every time.
We saw Tua Tagovailoa hit on some big ones in his college days to Henry Ruggs and Jerry Jeudy. That left arm, pretty underrated in terms of strength.
And as that ball was hanging in the air with the receiver streaking downfield to meet it, here in the stadium, you could just sense the crowd thinking, oh, no. And their worst fears were realized as that one turned into a long touchdown.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. To return is Jadon Mickens. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And with a three-score deficit staring them in the face, they might have to press the issue here and try to get points out of this drive. Meanwhile, Brady's throw complete here to his receiver, Brown. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. On first and 10, here's Brady. It's complete to Brown, right side. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. The catch and run pays off for 29 yards. A good grab there by the former Central Michigan man, Antonio Brown.
And he ate up some real estate on the catch too, didn't he? I think the most impressive part of it, though, if there's a chance for him to get the football, even though he was covered well, he somehow finds a way to get it.
To Evans on the slant. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Again, it's Brady. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And these guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Another tremendous play by Xavier Howard. 10 interceptions, led the NFL last year. And he's the first defender since Antonio Cromartie in 2007 with 10 or more in a season. When you throw it in his area, you're taking a gamble.
Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. The sack by the Super Bowl champion and Pro Bowler Jason Pierre-Paul. So we've reached halftime here, and it's the visiting Dolphins taking a lead to the locker room. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Final preparations being made for the second half, both in terms of game plan and also hydration, because humidity is really going to catch up to these guys, no doubt. And for the call of the second half, we go back to Brandon God.
Yeah, Coach. Hey, that goes for the announcers, too. No AC in this booth, so we've got a mash unit of empty water bottles up here as well. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in this second half?
Well, I like what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I'd keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be licensed to take some shots downfield.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Trick, trick. You got trick, you got
Tagovailoa working out of the gun. Oh, looking for Waddle, but it's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. And this one will be brought back to the 22. But pretty much everything went their way offensively in the first half, but now an interception on the opening drive of the third quarter.
As we know, the key to everything here, don't get careless with the football. The problem is, you've got to stay aggressive as well. So where's the line between being aggressive and attacking and being overly aggressive? I think they just crossed it on that one.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Gronkowski's got it on the crossing round. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. It's a gain of 11, and the Bucs have a first down.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
On the tackle there, Zach Sealer out of Ferris State. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Here's Brady. And a catch right side by Evans. And the Bucs are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the one.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover. And they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
Fournette. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
This Fournette territory here, and he's alone in the backfield on second and goal.
Check, 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 check.
Brady gonna throw. And he's got Gronkowski. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Rob Gronkowski. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Bucs capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six. Extra point put through by Succop. And the lead is trimmed down to 10. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. This now a 10-point game, so things tightening a little bit after that last score. He's going to float this over the middle deep. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
Throwing again on second and 10. Tua. He's letting this one go for Fuller. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown.
For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was incredible.
Well, in this league where coordinators worry so much about drawing up the right routes, blocking assignments, misdirections and stuff, they have these precise arrows and movements. Sometimes the best plays just come from the schoolyard where you look at your fastest guy and say, go long, go get it, big man.
Oh, the return is Mickens. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. The Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minute. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
First down catch there by O.J. Howard. Well done, and he's got to be excited because he missed a lot of the fun last year after suffering a torn Achilles back in week 4. But his head coach, Bruce Arians, says the sky's the limit for him in 2021 after rehabbing in the offseason.
Brady now on first down. And yet again, it's Howard with a catch. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. Right back to him for 10 more and a first.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
A lane to run there is Fournette, able to get about 7 on first down.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. They'll run it again with Fournette. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up 3rd down. Brady now to throw. Over the middle, that's taken in by Gronkowski. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there?
Yeah.
Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys? And Brady going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off by Jason McCourty. And he'll go down inside the 15 at his own 13-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
And he'll take this ahead for about 4. 2nd down coming up.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on 1st down.
And down he'll go at the 25.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
Setting to throw on 1st down is Tua. Yeah, the pressure gets there, and Tua is going to be taken down. Shaquem Griffin, he was relentless there as he hits home for the sack. And that is going to do it for this 3rd quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on 2nd and 16. Another try after the 1st down sack. Tua, he's going to rifle one deep left side. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. That ball nearly intercepted, but he could not hang on. Oh, a pick there certainly would have been nice. Instead, at least it'll be 4th down. Here's Michael Pilardi now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the 4th quarter. And he'll they'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Buccaneer offense will be set up well as they take over. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Jason McCourty. He's at the 30. 10. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
Now the Dolphins gonna burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Brown. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Malcolm Brown, his first touchdown on the year. And the Dolphins are well on their way to a 5-0 start as they extend their lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders, and the lead is now 24. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And their four-game win streak very much in jeopardy as they go to work here late with a first and 10. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. 2 yards the loss, and now they go from second and 2 to a tough third and 4. The Bucs on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 4. To throw is Brady. He's got it complete to Gronkowski. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Brady now on first down. This is caught. It's Brown. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Into the red zone, it's Brady. They'll swing this out to Fournette. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Not much there, only a yard.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam coming out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Now he's flushed out right. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
And while he did a good job of sliding around in the pocket, there was nowhere to go with the football, so he had to take off and try and run. He just got back to the line of scrimmage, no gain.
The Bucs on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 9. Here's Brady to throw. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Noah Igbinoghene. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. I think you and I were a little surprised back earlier in the game when he threw his second interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now 5 times?
It's beyond stunning to me because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience.
And the ball is knocked out. He'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 23.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free. But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. And they will take a knee here. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. And they'll indeed take a knee. Here's Michael Pilardi now as he'll kick it away for the second time. Seven-yard punt, a return of 4. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Eric Rowe, and he will return this one to the 30-yard line. Yet another interception, and I just had to double-check my math. But it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it, and sometimes they try too hard, and they never get out of it. And that's where he is right now. He's just locked in a really bad way.
Clock counting down toward 40 seconds as they take the knee. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now, third and long. And they take a knee. So a victory here for the Miami Dolphins. And of course, this is a win.